Welcome and a very good afternoon, everyone. So this is our assignment 2 project-based presentations, which is for management accounting course, and we are from group B by Dr. Ani Suryati binti Ahmad. So my name is Zahira binti Zainuddin and I am the first presenter. I will be explaining to you guys about our company backgrounds and management accounting practices that our company applies. So our company sells Pia Chokoja, which is sells Chokoja. This is our brand name with our brand logo. So our company name was Pia Sundaram Berhad and our brand name was Pia Chokoja, and type of product is Chokoja. Our business was basically sole proprietorship business. Therefore, it means we have one ownership. And if you want to find our HQ, you could find our company in Jalan Berdian 71800 in Nilai at Negeri Sembilan. This is some of our, this is all the staff that we have in our company, which is the founder, Muhammad Alif bin Rahman, also known as Managing Director. And the next one was Putri Nur Isha binti Muhammad Azra as our production manager. Not to forget our finance manager, which is Nurul Barizah binti Ahmad Zaki, and me as the marketing manager. So our types of company is basically imaginative company, and we also have a trademark for our brands. So which is exclusive taste with the best quality. So our company really focused to capture customers by satisfying their needs. So our company will be target for the youth, children and women adult who likely to have patience in chocolate. So at the beginning is, our company has made an assessment of the business of dessert and snacks that are around Nilai. From the review that we made, a conceptual idea was born, which is Chokoja. So about the company marketing, the company's marketing promoting the goods on Facebook and Instagram. We have a regular source of raw materials such as butter, chocolate, bubble rice and other flavoring essence. So this is some of our management accounting practices that our company applied, which is cost estimations and financial monitoring. It compromised that activities such as product pricing, calculation, budgeting and financial monitoring of the manufacturing process. So the next one is management information for planning and control. So productions and internal administrative in our company controls were prioritized over strategic considerations by the management. So adding value to available resources. This intervention will be carried out by analyzing the determinants of consumer happiness, stakeholder value and organizational innovation by using technology.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. My name is Puteri Nur Inshirah and now I'll proceed our presentation with costing elements and methods for our product. Okay, firstly, we have product cost, which also known as prime cost. For our prime cost, we have direct material and also direct labor. So as we can see here, RM6.40 is the total cost of direct material for one unit of Chokoja. And in daily basis, we can produce about 150 units of Chokoja and we have 22 days of working hours in a month. Therefore, our maximum production in 1 month would be 3,300 units of Chokoja. Okay, next, for direct labor, we decided to use the straight piece rate system, which directly dependent on the total number of output that a worker is able to produce. So in monthly basis, our maximum labor cost would be RM4,290. Then we move to the manufacturing overhead, or known as product cost. This is our variable cost in monthly basis, and as you can see here, we have the cost pool, cost driver, activity driver and also overhead absorption rate. So all these informations need to be noted as we are going to use activity-based costing later on to allocate overhead based on the activities that drive the cost. So the formula is easy, which needs you to just divide the cost pool with monthly activities to get its absorption rate. Okay, so the last category we have in product cost is the fixed cost production overhead, which costs us RM1,250 for 1 month. Now we move on to the period cost. Okay, in period cost, which also known as non-manufacturing overhead, the cost is the cost of selling and administrative expenses in our monthly basis would be RM3,700. Now, we move on to the activity-based costing, which is very useful for the pricing decisions and identifying cost activities. So this is the working which based on the basis of apportionment that we have decided before. After adding up all the costs here, the total production cost for 1 month is RM32,977. Therefore, our total production cost per unit will be RM10 as we produce 3,300 units in a month. So I think that's all from me. I'll pass to Bariza for the next section.
Now we move to the section 3, which is preparation of income statement. Regarding the production of kokoja for 2 months, our company provided this following detail, which is variable cost per unit that consists of direct material and direct labor, variable production overhead, selling price per unit, fixed production overhead, and fixed selling and administrative. For your information, our company produced 3,300 units and managed to sell 2,900 units in June 2020. But in July 2020, our company produced 3,000 units and managed to sell 3,400 units. As we already learned in Chapter 5, there are two techniques in preparation of income statement, which are marginal costing technique and absorption costing technique. For marginal costing technique, our income statement is shown on the screen. In calculating closing inventory, we must find the total unit cost first that consists of direct material, direct labor, variable production overhead that amount in RM17.44. So this is profit that we will got in June 2020 and this value will got in July 2020. For absorption costing technique, we calculate as the marginal costing, but in closing inventory, the total unit cost is different because it consists of direct material, direct labor, variable production overhead, and fixed production overhead. And we got this value for closing inventory, but in July 2020, we has no closing inventory because our company managed to sell all of our kokoja and we will get profit amount RM2,626 in June 2020 and we'll got RM3,602 in July 2020. So this is our profit comparison. For marginal costing technique, the profit we got in June 2020 is lower than July 2020. But for absorption costing technique, the profit that we got in June 2020 is higher than July 2020.
Assalamualaikum and hi everyone. My name is Muhammad Arif Rahman and I will be presenting the last part of the project-based assignment, which is the critical thought on the costing method. So the first one, to provide more accurate method of product costing that leading to more accurate pricing decision, our company come to a decision to use ABC costing, which is the activity-based costing, as our production costing. Despite the complexity to implement ABC costing in small and medium-sized enterprise like our company, ABC costing can clarify the real cost of operation that give more analytical and accurate perspective. Research made in 2020 stated that ABC can provide accurate measures of the activity cost whose intensity is not proportional to the volume of output produced. In SME, which is like our company, ABC can become a valuable management control tool with a positive impact on organizational performance. Based on the article entitled Activity Based Costing and Implication for Open Innovation 2020, it underlined that ABC costing system allows a strategic vision to the company by identifying its potentialities, its weakness and opportunities for improvement, activity that add or do not add the value, and reflecting the organizational dynamic. This show how important the implementation of ABC costing system in the development of our company. However, SME also going to face some difficulties in adopting ABC costing system in their company, especially in terms of financial and resources. Researchers have simplified the SME challenges in adopting ABC include the cost of implementing and maintaining the system, estimating the benefit associated with ABC, and integrating the system into the overall management structure. Another challenges of ABC costing are the employee require comprehensive training. Based on the research and the case study made year by year regarding the implementation of ABC, it has come to our view that activity-based costing is the most reliable, but it is still the most difficult and expensive to enforce. Although it is costlier, it still provides excellent data to allow managers to develop more profitable long-term decisions. And because of that, despite all difficulties and challenges, we still prefer to use ABC method in our company. That's all from us. Thank you very much.